Shohei, today we'll consider the size of our new machine.
Oh, it's good. Finally, our company situation is getting better.
Okay, so let's calculate mold clamping force of the new product. Do you know what mold clamping force is?
Of course. Do you remember how long I have been working in the plastic industry field? Mold clamping force is the power to clamp mold not to open by pressure inside mold when melted material injected to mold from cylinder. If the mold clamping force is small, burrs will occur, so it's necessary to select a molding machine that has bigger mold clamping force than the force that the mold tries to open. On the contrary, it's not good if the clamping force is too big since it would wear the mold, and consume a lot of electric power.
You really understand well.
And this is formula to calculate mold clamping force.
There is nothing to teach you.
First, we need to check the projected area of product. Ichiro, please measure it.
Okay, maybe you forgot I am senior.
The projected area is the area when you view the product from above. Don't forget to include runner as well. Next is mold internal pressure. Depending product thickness and preciseness, estimated mold internal pressure would be different. This time product is household product, so let's calculate as 40 megapascal.
Then input the figures in the formula.
Wait, is this safety ratio 1.2 essential? If we calculate including this figure, the machine size would bigger.
Exactly. But we always have to include this safety ratio, because we need to take into consider the fluctuation of mold internal pressure depends on material kinds or product shape.
I see.
Here is the result of calculation.
It's 144 ton force. So, we need to choose J180 ADS.
Right. Next, we will choose injection unit.